The Lord is here. He said, where two or three people gather in my name, in their midst, I will be. If you have never believed that God is alive and that God is sure to his word, believe from today that God is able to fulfill his word in your life in Jesus' name. Amen. Holy Spirit will help me. What he wants you to hear, he will speak in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus Christ. Dominion and prosperity. Dominion and prosperity. Every man, every woman is born to dominate and to subdue in life. Genesis 1:26. Everyone is born to dominate. Genesis 1:16, the Bible says, the Lord made two great lights. The greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night. He made the stars also. And since that time, sun has been ruling, moon has been ruling, and the stars have been ruling. And all of them, they have their degrees of ruling. So every man, every woman that is born is ordained to rule. But that man will not rule until he knows the counsel of God for his life, the purpose of God for his life. That man, until he knows, he will not rule. Psalm 115 verse 16 says, heaven of heavens is of the Lord, but he has given to the children of men the heart to rule. But the heart he has given to the children of men. So this weekend, you're talking about dominion. You're talking about dominating. And we said in the first service, success comes to you by what you have been made of. By what you have become in life, that is what attracts success. If you have made up yourself that you have invested in your life 10% and you are 10% personality, 10% success will attract and come to you. But if you increase to 50, you will discover that your level will change, your friends will change. Before, you used to be a sole proprietor, one-man business. Now, you increase to 35%, you need someone to partner with you. Then you have someone in your life. And suddenly you said, no, I want to move to 70%. He said, no, this kind of structure, two people cannot run it. We need five, we need 10, we need shareholders. And that's why we increase, even in spiritual realm. Until your capacity inside increases, you don't attract success. It is what is inside of you that we bring people around you to say, we know you can do it. We can bring our money. We know if we give you 10,000 rand, you can make 25,000 rand out of it. But if you don't have anything inside of you, nothing will come. So dominion is expressed in the divine investment that is in you, that is manifesting in every area of your life, not only in finances, but also in your marriage, over your children, in your academics, in your family. This dominion investment is to manifest. And we said in Psalm 37:3-7, that the Lord said, commit your ways unto the Lord. Rest in him, and he will bring it to pass. If you look at verse 23 of this scripture, Psalm 37:23, he said, the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delights in his way. Now, we concluded in the first service, Until you begin to pursue the will and the counsel of God for your life, you cannot dominate. Joshua 1:8 says, this book of the Lord shall not depart from your mouth. He said, you shall meditate in it day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written in it. All that is written in it. All that is written in it. For then you will make your way prosperous. Let me tell you, my beloved brethren, as we emphasized in the first service, there's something that is written about you. There's something that is written. And we said, until you see yourself, you know, we said this. Many people, they say, it does not matter. Until you see yourself on the pages of the scriptures, dominion is far from you. Until you see yourself, whenever you get there, you know, the Bible is big. But when you get to that page, oh, say, this is me. Thank you, Jesus. This is me. You will bring it to pass. In Hebrews chapter 10, verse 7, concerning Jesus, he said, then I said, behold, I have come. You need to come to a point in your life that all your will, you gather it and you submit it to the will of God. You need to get to that point in your life. I need to get to that point that I will say, Lord, it is not of him that will or run. It's you that show mercy. These are my wills. These are my counsels. But I bring it to you. He said, then I said, behold, I have come in the volume of the book. It is written of me to do your will, O God. Whether you are a sister, whether you are a brother, there's something that is written concerning you. Psalm 40 verse 5 says, there are many of them. There are many of them. There are many of them. He said, there are wonderful works which have been done, and your thought towards me cannot be recounted. He said, they are more than can be numbered. So as many as they can be, you need to look for them. You need to seek them. You need to say, Lord, what is written concerning me? What is written concerning me? I don't want to just live my life outside your counsel. And we said, if you catch an eagle, as big and strong eagle can be, just put it inside that blowbug bish. You will discover that the eagle will die because that is not his area of dominion. So many of us, we have been operating outside our area of dominion and we say we want to dominate. No, it does not happen that way. I beg you. It doesn't happen. You must find yourself in that which is written concerning you. You might be saying, this thing is difficult. How do I know the will of God? How do I walk in it? How? How do I find rest? Some of us, your mother told you one or two things. Still, despite the fact that your mother told you, you didn't look for it. Your mother told you before you were born, this is what God told me. Still, you are not walking in it. So, if you are not walking in the one that has been said to you, how will you look for the one that you don't know? How will you pursue the one that you don't know? Ephesians 1:11 says, there are things that have been ordained before the foundation of the world. And they wrap them up and call it inheritance. In him also we have obtained an inheritance, being predestined according to the purpose of him who works all things according to the counsel of his will. Counsel of his will. He works all things according to the counsel of his will. Listen, if you are working in FMB, your uniform is different from Absa. So, manager of Absa cannot harass you inside FMB, though you go there to withdraw. You just quickly take excuse from your boss. Please, I want to withdraw in FMB. And you get to ATM outside. They said, no, please go inside. And you are wearing your uniform. You enter. FMB manager cannot harass you. and said, you are wearing bank uniform. You know we work in the bank. Why are you not on your seat? Because he has no rights. When you are outside the will of God, there's nothing anybody can do. You are on your own. You're on your own. So you said it is difficult. Pastor, it's difficult. I agree with you. It's difficult. Because you are still in the flesh. That's why we celebrate Holy Spirit. That's why we celebrate Holy Spirit. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 5, verse 7, that even Jesus, when he was in the flesh, he needed to fulfill the will of God for his life. He did something. Even Jesus, the Son of God, that said in John chapter 17, verse 4, I have finished what you asked me to do on earth. Even Jesus. So if you want to dominate, if I want to dominate, let me tell you, it is outside you. You need to go to him that has everything in his hand. And say, Lord, I know this thing, except you, it can't be fulfilled. So Jesus, in Hebrews chapter 5, verse 7, he said, Jesus, being in the flesh, he prayed. He offered prayers. He wanted to do the will of God, but it was difficult for him. In quote, being in the flesh. Being in the flesh. He went to God and he prayed. You want the will of God to be done in your life? You want to dominate? You need to pray. Many of us say, come and pray. He said, don't worry. Whatever will be, will be. I have my car, I have my house, I have my children, I have my wife, or I have my wives. He offered prayer with tears, with supplication, with vehement cries and tears to him who is able to save him from death. And it was hard. That's why Jesus resurrected. The plan of the hell is for him not to resurrect. So when he resurrected, they regretted it. If it dawned on them that as he's going to die, he's going to resurrect, they won't kill him. They won't kill him. And it was hard because of his ungodly, of his godly fear. Verse 8. Though he was a son, shall we please rise? Though he was a son of God. I don't know who I'm speaking to. Though Jesus was the Son of God, yet he went for training. Though he was the Son of God, he started learning how to do the will of God. He obeyed when he discovered the will of God. Brethren, I want you to pray. We don't have much prayer. The Lord Almighty has come down to help us to fulfill his will for our lives. But I just want you to pray. I don't know your bank account. I don't know your investment. I don't know your connection. But if you are not connected to him that owns all things, sorry, it's like a fish inside the cage of a bird. I want you to bow your heads and pray. I want you to say, Lord Jesus, hijack me, uphold me, to be at the center of your will all the days of my life. Go ahead and pray. Go ahead and pray.